Before you watch this video, I need to give it a mini introduction because, oh my gosh, in this video I went to all like the movie locations and like I felt like I was in a film all day. And then I had the most movie moment, like New York based scene in my life. It's just so freaking cool. And I can't believe it was my life and I lived it. Good morning, beautiful. I almost just dropped the camera on the floor, but I'm gonna give you an outfit of the day. Nice, easy, breezy. And then we have a whole pack of Blistex plasters and 3 pairs of socks. So my feet are solid and nothing's gonna happen to them today. They're gonna be so comfy, like, it's great, it's all happening. Yeah, we are, this is actually insane. Started off every single day in New York by going to Times Square and grabbing a coffee and sitting there, and that was like my mini grounding moment of people watching and just feeling like, fuck yeah, I'm in New York. But this is all the kind of like b-roll kind of walking around footage that I got, so I guess in the most cheesiest way possible, come walk around New York with me.
Bro, you're late to the party, bro.
Oh, party.
You're late to the party.
Looking for love, real love, ridiculous, inconvenient, consuming, can't live without each other love.
Well, you know everything's gonna be a breeze. Then we'll no doubt justify the means. We can fix any problem with the slightest of ease. Yes, please. But you might find out it'll go to your head when you write a report on the book you never read. With the snap of your fingers, you can make your bed.
And whilst this place from the film doesn't actually exist, Bleecker Street does, and it did feel strange down there.
Now we need the semen of a righteous man. You know what? If we had that, we wouldn't be doing the ritual in the first place.
You know what's really cute is that this day I actually bought this jumper. Movie bits that I did, and they're literally like all like within like a couple blocks of each other, so like they're all in the same area. I didn't pay for any like extra internet package or anything, so I only used Wi-Fi, but maps still work when you're out. Blue Dot still moves along with you, so you can kind of find out where you're going. You just can't route things, but that's fine. It was boiling hot. I was like trying to cover up in my shawl because I was gonna burn. Like, and when you're on your own, that you can't like lean against anyone, or I felt like I couldn't let my guard down. So it was very, yeah. We stopped at Statue of Liberty, and I looked at the queue of people like getting back on the boat, and I was like, I'm not doing that. So I just stayed on the boat. I got kind of close to her, and I was happy about that. And I got an exclusive Statue of Liberty magnet, so. Still happy with the experience, sat around Ellis Island, and it was cool, like, on the boat as well. Did feel actually very, very seasick, but I got some cool footage, and, you know, I'm glad looking back on it, and it was kind of, like, cosy and sweet, and I got to sit down, and... randomly asked out in New York, like my second day there. But at the time I was like, look, I'm gonna live my best, I'm not the drone's life. And yeah, so I didn't really take much footage. I didn't like get ready for the day on camera or anything, but I did take quite a lot of photos. You know, I got to see some cool places which I wouldn't have seen otherwise, and also had a Manhattan because like obviously you have to. Which is, I'm such a dweeb. It was like such a cool movie moment, like getting to see like the skyline and being out at night time, because I didn't go out at night time by myself, so that was really cool. Nice experience.
Hello.
Good morning, my love. So, I'm filming today. I'm filming like a little morning routine, right? I'm also forgot to tell you that I got this jumper, which I love, but your little English girl here loves the rain, and it's meant to rain like any second now for like an hour. So I need to quickly hop in the shower, get ready, and get the fuck outside because I fucking love the rain and rain in New York, like, yes, yes. So, but yeah, I was really, really tired yesterday, but I had a fun evening, which I can tell you all about. But let me hop in the shower. So the date, it went well. It was nice. He actually invited me out for like tonight. I'm not gonna turn down a local showing in New York. Absolutely not. So that was super fun. Yeah, I didn't take the subway at all. I probably should have, but I walked all the way to Chinatown and back and got to see some more like Sex and the City sites, which was fun. But I wanted to go to Chinatown because this shop is like big on TikTok and it photographs your aura. I know places in London do this, but like it's Chinatown in New York. Like, come on. It's like a tiny, tiny little shop, like no photography in there whatsoever. Almost it's like an electric chair that you have to like sit on and like have your aura done. And then they do like a little reading for you afterwards. So yeah, it was really cool and kind of just as expected. You know, if you're into that sort of thing, you're into it, but if not, you're not. But like I said previously, I didn't have any internet, so as soon as I could get Wi-Fi, I lapped it up. And this day, I like learned all my lessons. I sat, I rested, I didn't just walk the full like length of New York. So I sat and rested in Starbucks on my way home, FaceTimed my mom. But this lady that served me in the Starbucks, absolute dream, I loved her. So she basically helped me out. I literally gave her this like massive handful of change and she was like, it's fine, like if I came to London, I wouldn't know either and you would help me. And I was like, I love you, I love you. Hello, I don't have any towels in my room. If I can get some, please. No, that's it, that's perfect, thank you. You too, bye.
Might ask you.